Now let's talk about state. Now how we have to work with state. Just a minute. Let me show you the example of state now. Okay. So we till now we have talked about components, we have talked about JSX, we have talked about props, right? Now what we are going to do is that we are going to talk about now state, that what is a state now. So we'll start with react-dom.render. Now what is there in react-dom.render? In react-dom.render we have element, right? Yes. This element is calling what?
Component, stopwatch.
Component. So what is the name of the component? Stopwatch.
Stopwatch.
What are these two things? Running and lapse. So these are the props. These becomes your props, running and lapse. Correct? Then we will go to the stopwatch component. Let's go to the stopwatch component. Okay, so this is the stopwatch component, right? What type of component it is? It's not a function component, it's a class component, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so I told you that you can very well create function components, but when you have to deal with the state, when you have to maintain the initial state, when you have to maintain the final state, then you have to always create a class component. Correct? Now, yeah. In this, I am setting the initial state as lapse equal to 0, running false. Initial state. Okay? Now, I am declaring a method over here called handle run click. Handle run click. In this handle run click, I am setting the state. So how you set the state? Please remember you set the state with the method this dot set state. This dot set state. Okay. Now before doing this handle run click or handle clear click, let's see the render method. That is how we declare the render method and having a return statement. This is your render method. I told you every class component has a render method and a return inside it, a return statement. Yeah, so every class component. So how we create a class component? I told you that there will be class. So let's say my demo extends react.component, or you can directly write component, no problem at all. Then you directly will write render. In this render method, you will have a return statement. That's how we talked about a class component, creating a yes. class component.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah, so same thing I have done. If you see in this example, I have declared some handlers, or you can say events, that is handle run click and handle clear click. So let's go to the render method first of all directly. In render method, const lapse running equal to this dot state. And I'm declaring some, you can say styling, const button styles. And this is the return statement. This is very important. Actual HTML is written here. So you see here how many controls are there? Label, button, and button. Now you can understand what will be the output, right? There will be a label. There will be two buttons. Yes or no?
Yes, correct. Correct. Correct.
Correct. This label has some styling. What will be the text of this label is this lapse millisecond, correct?
Yeah.
What will be value in the lapse? It will be shown in the label. So this label yeah. part is clear, right? Now the second button. Second control is button. So this button, on this button, I am calling, there is an on-click event, correct?
Yeah.
So on click event, I am calling a method called handle run click. On the other button, I am calling handle clear click. Right? I am applying some style. Style is equal to button style. Style equal to button style. Now, what will be the text? So, second button text is pretty forward. What will be the text?
Clear.
The second button text is clear, but the first button text is dependent on a condition. If running is true, then it will show the text as stop. Else it will always show the text as
start.
Correct. Now let's go to these methods. Now what we are doing in these methods, handle run click and handle clear click. So handle clear click is pretty straightforward. There is a by default JavaScript method called clear interval. We are clearing the interval of the timer and we are setting the state again back to zero and running equal to false. So this is, you must be understanding that this is kind of a stopwatch kind of application which I have created. You understand what is stopwatch, right? You start the stopwatch, you can stop the stopwatch. So this is kind of a stopwatch kind of application which I have created. Now what is there in the handle run click? Handle run click, I'm setting the state. If state dot running means if it is true, then you have to call the clear interval, else there will be some calculations where I'm setting the state. Now let's check the output of this, then probably you can understand it more. Okay. Can you see the output?
Yeah, two buttons and one label we have.
Two buttons and one label. Initial value of lapse is zero. That's why it is showing you zero. Let's click on this start. Can you see the timer has started?
Yes.
And the text of the start has been changed to?
Stop.
I have stopped. If I click on clear, can you see again it has been cleared?
Yes, it has become zero.
It has again become the zero. So now you can correlate. If I click on start, it is changing to stop. And if I click on clear, it is completely clear. So that is how we have implemented this, that there will be a label and there will be two buttons and there will be two separate, you can say handlers, event handlers for these two buttons. Any questions? Did you got the idea that how we are managing the state? So let me tell you one more time. Let's see here. What was the initial state? Initial state was lapse 0, running false. And how you set the state? You set the state by using the command this dot set state. So this dot set state is a method. Now when the timer is running, what I am setting the state, this dot set state, lapse will become date dot now minus start time. This is a calculation, just a calculation, and I'm setting the interval. And if state dot running, if state is running, so you see here, if I click on start and I click on clear, that's why it is calling clear interval. You see here which method is called? Clear interval. In this clear interval, what it is setting the state?
To zero.
Again to zero. And that is happening. Why it is setting the state? So this dot set state, lapse becomes zero, which is perfectly fine. How come it is becoming stop? Again start. So if I click on clear, this stop button will become start. That is why I have to set this property also. Why I have to set this property? Because the text of this button is a ternary operator. I have shown you the ternary operator, right?
Yeah.
It will only show start when running is false.
Correct.
It will show stop when running is true.
When it is running, it will show stop. And when it is clear, it will show start.
Yeah. So in the clear interval, what we are doing, running equal to false.
Yes.
In the handle clear click method, this is the handle clear click method.
Yeah.
We are setting the state. In the setting the state, what we are setting the value of the running property? False.
False.
So whenever this button will be clicked,
the value will become start.
The value will become start.
Yes.
If I click on start and I click on clear, I'm setting the state as false. You see here, lapse become zero. Lapse become zero. And the text change to start. Okay.